What's up, everyone? I'm ready for the gym. Outfit. Let's talk outfit. Oh, shit. Okay, shoes. Belt. Zipper down, goddammit. Oh, wait a minute. Look at that. Gold zipper. Gold belt. Gold watch. And wait a minute. Boom. What the fuck is that? A gold motherfucking knife. Yeah. Oh, what am I? Look at that shit. Oh, god damn it.
Sick.
Yeah, I think that's just going a little, what do you think?
I think it looks cool.
A little
awesome.
Overboard, babe?
No, I think it looks
great. A little too much? A little too much gold and shit?
Nah, sick as fuck.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All I need is the gold grill.
Right? Oh,
the gold killer hat. See, I could have put the gold fucking shirt on, but that would have been way overboard. So I was with a plain shirt.
Right.
But I could get the gold grill. What do you think, babe? No, I'm good. I'm ready.
Right.
So I think I outdid you today, babe. I think I fucking outdid you. My outfit is fucking killing your outfit. What you gotta say about that shit?
Right. Yeah. Yeah, I think you did. Definitely.
So we are on our way to North Hollywood.
Yeah.
And we're gonna film Robert Wiley.
Yep.
Robert Wiley. When I met him, he was a teenager and with tons of potential, big ass teenager, really fucking good kid. And, bodybuilding is his life. You know, he fucking loves bodybuilding. He lives for bodybuilding. It reminds me of when I was a teenager. Except Robert's a good kid. I was a little motherfucker. That's the difference. But we had the same interests and, you know, I can relate with his passion and he has it. And, you know, he competed as a teenager. He actually went in a couple men's fucking classes and fucking won as a teenager. So that's some pretty fucking incredible shit. That's one thing I didn't do. As a teenager, I never competed in men's. I just competed in teenage, won pretty much every teenage show I did. You know, at the age of 18 and 19, I won every show I ever did. When I was 15 through 17, I didn't win every show. So, I didn't win my first show until I was 18, you know, but when I was, imagine being 15 years old and competing against 19 year olds, you know, it's kind of fucking 15 year old. You're still like, in my opinion, a little fucking kid, you know, 19, you're a grown fucking man in my opinion. So it's a big difference between 15 and 19. But anyway, so we're going to film. He just won his class at the California in the men's open. So that's a big ass show. So it's awesome that at his young age, he actually won his class. So he's doing really good. And I'm pretty sure he's going to do the USA's this year. And, you know, he has a good chance of winning his class in the USA's. So we'll hope for that win. And we're driving Sarah's car because we haven't driven her car in weeks. And when we came outside today, her air suspension was fucking slammed on the ground on one side. So people out there that have Mercedes or have had Mercedes, you know that if you don't drive it for a certain amount of time, the fucking all of a sudden the air suspension just fucking drops. And so one corner of the car was like almost on the ground. Like,
yeah,
what the fuck?
We were like, what the hell is going on?
It looks like the whole fucking car's busted, you know?
Right.
So, you know, you just put the key in, turn it on, start it, and it fucking pops right back up, and it's all good. But it's definitely not good to let the car sit and not drive that shit.
You know,
it's the worst thing is to just let a car sit. So, we decided to drive it, and it's a fucking mess. It's embarrassing. Can't even see out the goddamn window. Dirty as fuck. But, you know, our car wash guy's at the gym.
So we're going to get it washed. We're
going to wash it while we train. When we come out from the gym, the car will look brand fucking new.
Right.
All fucking good.
Yeah.
So the only problem is all my fucking information's in the other car. So I don't have my license. I don't have my insurance. I don't have any of my nothing. It's all in the other fucking car. So hopefully I don't get pulled over. And I shouldn't be speeding right now like I am.
Right.
But we're late as fuck.
Uh-huh.
In fact, I need to actually text him and let him know because we're over a half an hour late. Like, that's fucked up. Robert's a really nice kid, and he's the kind of person that gets there early, you know?
Right.
And the way we should be, you know. And there's people out there that, you know, they truly believe it's better to be, you know, it's better to be 20 minutes early than to be 1 minute late, you know. And that's an important saying, because it is. And, you know, being punctual, a lot of people take that shit seriously. Like, there's people out there that they'll judge you 100% on you know, being late or being early or whatever. And I've known people that they, you know, in the business world, that they absolutely 100% cannot deal with people that are fucking late. And they will not work with, have worked for them, anyone that's fucking late. Because, you know, it does kind of tell a lot about a person, you know. It's just complete fucking irresponsibility. And, you know, I have to say that I'm a late as fuck. I've been that way since I was a kid. I was late to school every fucking day. You know, when I used to have a training business, I was late. But what was good is Sarah can relate. It was funny. We had a laugh about it when we first met, is that, you know, when I had a training business, I'd have 12 clients a day, right? Well, I was notoriously late every day for my first client, right? But the other clients, I was on time for because I was already there. So out of my 12 clients, 11 of them thought I was fucking perfect because I was never late, because I was always there. So, because I couldn't be late because I was already at the gym, right? So 11 of my clients would rave about how punctual I was. And that one first client, you know, knew that I was just like, you know, a complete fuck up. And so, and Sarah, she said she was the same way when she went to college, is that she'd be late every day to her first class.
Yeah.
And then all the rest of the class, she was on time because she was already there.
Yeah.
So one teacher, you know, would fucking out of her fucking mind, and the rest of them thought you were the fucking best student, right?
Yeah.
That's how I was in school too, but I never went to college. So that's how I was in high school. Yeah. Fucking always late to that first class. Always late.
Yeah.
Hopefully he didn't leave.
Huh?
Hopefully he didn't leave.
Do you think so?
I said hopefully.
Yeah, I know, but do you think he would?
No, I think he would text if he was going to leave, you know?
Yeah.
But I didn't text him back and say we're running late or anything until just right now, and it's fucking 11:36.
Jeez.
Fuck, man. I mean, we had a good excuse, a really good excuse that we can't even fucking share on camera.
No.
But it's a really fucking, there is no better fucking excuse, honestly.
Right. We will share it with him. But not the camera. Not you guys, sorry.
We have so much shit we can't share. It fucking sucks.
I know.
People knew all this shit, our videos would be fucking viral as fuck.
I know.
But I have to announce that I've had a little idea of coming out with, you know, I've had a different idea of like doing another YouTube channel. You know, I've had this idea for probably like a good two to three years. And it's a fucking
awesome idea.
Awesome idea and fun as fuck.
Everyone
funny
gonna love
as
it.
Fuck. Best fucking. I mean, the shit is gonna be. It's gonna be incredible.
Yeah.
And I never did it, and I think I'm finally gonna do it. And it's a little video series I'm gonna do it with Sarah, and it's gonna be funny as fuck.
Yeah.
As fuck. Educational at the same time.
Yeah.
It's just all around good ass fucking videos. So
right.
We're probably gonna try to film some in the next couple days and maybe throw one up,
mm-hmm.
you know, in the next week or so. And I'll probably throw one of those up like once a week or something.
Yeah.
And this shit is fucking awesome.
Yeah.
So here's our car wash guy.
Right. Hey, Harry. Woo.
Fucking try to park somewhere here. By where he's fucking working, which there is nowhere to fucking park.
Right.
But I will find a motherfucking place. I'm gonna park in the middle of the fucking intersection.
Woo!
You know what? I think I'm just gonna park right here. Fuck it.
Right.
Right in the middle of the fucking street. Alright, babe. I gotta run in there. Oh, you gotta run in too.
Yeah.
So, I guess you can cut the camera for now.
Okay.
I gotta get her. So today, Robert and I are going to train back. And the reason being is it was back and bicep day for him, and he's in training mode. He just got done competing, getting ready for another show. So I was working around his schedule. So it was back and buys. And the crazy thing was I actually trained back the day before. So I'm hitting back 2 days in a row. But
I got to say, man, we did different exercises and it was a great workout. The first exercise was shoulder width pull downs, reverse grip to the chin. And I have to say that this is something I never do. And, you know, this was, I believe, Dorian Yates probably made this exercise popular. And I have to say that it actually was really good. You know, I really felt it in the mid and lower lats, got a really good stretch. And, you know, I always thought that this exercise was just too much bicep. But I have to say that I actually got a really good pump, and I'm actually going to use this exercise in the future. So thanks, Robert, for this helpful hint. And I'm definitely going to use this exercise more often. It's definitely a good one. So that was good. So next, we went on to pullovers, which normally I use a wide grip on these. He uses more of a narrow grip, which, you know, I have to say that it was different. And I got to be honest that I feel like I feel a little more in my lats when I use a wider grip. And so this one, I tend to feel a little bit more in my lower lats. And I actually can feel a little bit in the middle of my back. So it's crazy how much that slight grip change contains the exercise so much. So again, something different. So that's always good. Then we went on to hammer strength rows, seated rows. And another exercise I never do. You know, North Hollywood has had this fucking machine for 30 years since they opened. And I have never liked it, never used it. And, you know, he wanted to do those. So I said, sure, let's do it, goddammit. And I got to say that it was pretty good. You know, the way that machine works is, you know, it's heavier in the beginning. And as you pull it, it seems to get a little lighter. So I felt it a little more in the lower lats. And as I pulled, it worked the way up to the upper. So, you know, it's definitely something different. And definitely something that, you know, shocked my back into some new growth, hopefully. And I have to say it was, you know, another good exercise, something I never do. So next we went to T-bar rows, supported. And this one is one I do, you know, quite a bit. And this really hits the middle of the back. You know, it really bombs. You can really feel when you contract, you can feel exactly where this exercise works. And the thickness down the middle of the back is exactly where this exercise hits. And, you know, that area of my back, I'm pretty happy with. So I don't really need to do those as often as I do. Now we went to regular standing T-bar rows next, you know, which is the harder of the two. And this one I feel hits the whole back. You know, this one really incorporates the lats. And by just a simple movement of the exercise, I can feel it more in my back. I feel it all over and I feel like I have more control and I can kind of figure out what part of the back I want to hit depending on how high up I go, how low, how wide my grip, you know. So this is again one of my favorite exercises. And as you can see, Robert went with a narrow grip and I went with a wide grip. So, you know, it's all personal preference and it's all about what you feel when you're doing the exercise. That's most important. So done with back, moving on to biceps. We did barbell curls, which is something I never do. You know, I tore my bicep about 15 years ago. And ever since then, I've had a problem doing, you know, free weight curls. So I stay away from them. But, you know, we went fairly light and I got a good pump. And again, it was something different. And we used the curl bar, which is definitely easier on the wrist. And it allows me to get a better squeeze on top. So, you know, these were great. And, you know, this is... Again, this is most people's number one bicep exercise. For me, I never really felt that it was one of the best bicep exercises. I prefer dumbbells and cables, you know, at least for muscle development. But it was great to do something different. And again, I was going along and following Robert's workout, and it was definitely a great workout. So next we went to dumbbell preacher curls, which is something I normally do. And, you know, these are great. And you get a good squeeze on top, a good stretch, and also they look great on camera, right? So, yeah, these are one of my favorite. And Robert has great biceps, as you can see, has a great peak, you know, and the peak is genetic. You know, I have more of a flat bicep. When I come up and flex, you know, it's pretty flat, which is just genetic. You know, you just can make your arms bigger. So then we went on to preacher hammer dumbbell curls. And this one, we went on an incline bench. And this exercise really isolates the brachialis, the bicep, and also incorporates the forearm. So this is a great fucking exercise. And these are something I don't really do that often, but I really should. It really is a great exercise. And I have to say that it was a great workout, and it was great following someone else and letting them choose the exercises and just follow along. And again, it was a great workout, and we fucking killed that shit. And there's Sarah fucking doing a quick selfie in between filming us, of course.
Hey, what's up, everyone? We just finished training, and it is shake motherfucking time. I killed back with Robert, back and buys. Good-ass fucking workout. And then Sarah killed glutes, so I filmed that shit. So I took a little break, had a shake, brought two motherfucking shakes today. And then I trained calves. So I've been at the gym for like, what, 3 hours, babe?
Yeah. So, fucking awesome. Woo. Killing it.
My second motherfucking shake. God damn it. It is fucking hot out.
I know.
It's at least 90 right now.
Oh, we should go to the pool. Awesome.
Yeah, the pool's fucking ready. I put the heat on yesterday, so the heat's probably too fucking hot.
Oh, let's go to the pool.
So, yeah, we'll go fucking
and tan.
Swim. We're going to swim tonight.
Yeah.
Go for a little night swim. Right. That's what I'm talking about.
Skinny dip. Throw China in the fucking pool. Aye. So. But we should go now, and I need a tan, babe. This albino here needs a tan.
Yep. So, right here, there's police behind you. Today, right now, about 10 minutes ago, babe.
Yeah?
What's that? No, we just left the gym. We heard that there's something going on, but yeah, we didn't see it. Yeah, sorry. But the employees inside, I think, saw it. I think he saw it. He did it. I think he saw it.
Yeah, there was a big-ass fight in the park. Like 10 against 10 baseball bats. Fucking crazy shit. But you know, this is the fucking ghetto. That's why I call it the North Hollywood Ghetto Golds.
Right.
Ghetto ass fucking shithole. But, you know, yeah, so I guess there was a big ass gang fight. So
crazy shit.
Crazy shit in North Hollywood.
Right.
But whatever.
Yeah. I'm starving. And they just washed my car. It's so pretty. Yeah.
Let's go.
Yeah.
So yeah, this we're gonna drive over where that fucking fight was going on over here.
Right.
Yeah, this shit's all over with now. You see cops rolling around, but those motherfuckers took off.
God damn it, we missed all the fun. Shit.
Missed all the action.
Shit.
That was, I heard it was like 10 on 10. Fucking, they had baseball bats and shit, and they were going at it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Fuck.
It's fucking gone now. Shit.
Right? God damn it. They're too late.
Oh, man. That was a good ass workout.
Yeah. Awesome workout.
Fuck, killed my calves.
Right?
Well, because yesterday I did the 100 rep drop set.
Oh, yeah, shit.
Fucking killed him yesterday and then killed him again today.
Awesome.
Motherfucking shoes are shit training calves.
I know, right?
Fucking total shit. These right here?
Yeah.
There's no, like, fucking padding on the bottom of it.
Oh, shit.
It's, like, unbelievable.
Right?
It's just like cars, man. The more money you spend on a fucking car, the more fucking problems it is. The same with shoes. The more you spend on shoes, the shittier they are. My most expensive shoes are my most fucking uncomfortable, fucking shitty ass. It's unbelievable.
Man. Right.
It just goes to show that it's all, you know, it's all about fucking hype and marketing and popularity. And
right.
It don't matter how good the product is. It's fucking bullshit. Shoes are shit.
Yeah.
Go to Big Five and buy, you know, a fucking pair of whatever for $29 and show up. I could, you know, you could run miles and fucking feel good.
Cobb salad?
Yeah.
Okay.
And yeah, the other one, toss blue cheese, and then that's it.
Alright, so we have one bacon burger, medium rare with a salad, honey mustard dressing on the side, protein style, that means it'll be wrapped in lettuce. Bacon burger, medium rare with salad, dressing on the side, blue cheese dressing, protein style as well. One Cobb salad, toss with blue cheese dressing, one Cobb salad, toss with honey mustard. Again,
right, thank you.
This is gonna be interesting.
Well, we're not gonna be there before 11. Should we not even go? Should we just go to the Habit and just fuck them? Let them fuck up our meal? No, seriously.
Because it's like...
Wait, did I give her my phone number?
No.
Oh, I didn't. Yeah, so...
They are going to... We are gonna be there like 11:50.
I know.
Yeah.
So what do you want to do? Should we just go to the Habit and not even go? No, seriously. I mean, she was a bitch.
I know.
She was a fucking bitch.
Yeah. I know. Like, okay, Jesus. Yeah, let's just go to Habit and she can just make the order and just like F you, god damn it.
Yeah, I can't believe that. I'm like, I'll be there, I could be there at 11:02. She's like, nope, you gotta be there at 11. I wish we had that on film, damn it. Nope, you gotta be there at 11. You gotta be there, doors locked at 11, you gotta be there at 11. Like, we come all the time to Cheesecake Factory.
Right.
Like 11:02, 11:03, and they always open the door for you.
Right.
Oh shit, we passed the fucking Habit anyway, babe.
Oh shit.
Yeah, fuck it. Fuck her. Now they're gonna fucking make all that food and it's gonna go to waste.
Right? Ha ha. Wow, unbelievable.
Fucking so stupid.
Right?
I think they have my number.
Saved?
Yeah, I think it's on their phone, so they'll call me back. They'll be like, and then I'm just gonna tell the manager, we'll be like, well, I told her I could be there at 11:02, and she said, absolutely not. You gotta be here at 11. We're locking the doors at 11, and I'll say, you know, honestly, 11:02 wasn't good enough, so I didn't even try to come.
Right.
I say, just in the future, say we order food here all the time, and they always are fine with us getting there at 11:02. It's never been a problem.
Right.
So, since it was a problem this time,
we were like, fuck it.
Yeah, we just, so you guys basically ate that because of her. So, and I'll probably call back tomorrow night and do the same thing.
Right? You're gonna be the number one.
Man, yeah, so people
customer
out there, we fucking tried to order Cheesecake Factory, which we do all the time, and it's 6 minutes to 11. Let me see. Well, it's 11 now. So it's 11 o'clock, and the girl's like, we're going to close at 11. Can you be here by 11? And I said, well, probably 11:02, which I wouldn't be there by 11:02. We wouldn't have been there until like 11:10 at the quickest. But usually that's fine at Cheesecake Factory. Usually they're cool about that. All restaurants are cool because they're cleaning the restaurant and it's not a big deal.
Right.
And she's like, no, you gotta be here by 11. You gotta be here at 11. We lock the doors at 11 and we don't open them for anybody. That's what she said.
Like, jeez.
Like, wow, they open for me every fucking time for the last fucking 10 years.
Right.
Wow.
Someone's in a bad mood.
Yeah. So we ordered the food. I ordered the food anyway, like, and we're just not gonna go pick it up. Fuck them. You know? I mean, she's like being a bitch for no reason. So I gotta be a dick back and order the food and not pick it up, right?
Right.
And she basically said that she was not gonna open the doors if I got there after 11. And
yeah,
after I ordered, I looked at my phone and I was not gonna get there by 11. So what's the point of driving there and having her turn me down, right?
Right.
So, we are going to the Habit, I guess.
Again.
So, we got the pool heated.
Yeah.
So, we might take a little dip in the pool tonight when we get home. A little late night swim. And take China swimming. Oh, we need to get her some fucking tennis balls, babe. Is there any places open right now? Past 11? CVS or Walgreens? You know, that's open till midnight? I don't think so. Like, only... Like downtown, I think, are the ones 24 hours.
Right.
I don't know. I'm not really sure. So Sarah's dad is coming to visit us.
Yep.
I've never met Sarah's dad. He couldn't make it to the wedding, so I've not met him to this day. So it's kind of exciting news. Yeah, see, this is Rite Aid. It's closed.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's exciting news.
Yep. It comes in a week.
So he's gonna be staying at the house. How long is he staying for? Like a couple weeks?
10 days.
10 days. That's cool. That's awesome. awesome. Sarah's dad is a workout maniac, from what I hear.
Yep.
He loves working out.
He lives in the gym.
He lives in the gym. So that's awesome.
Yeah.
So we'll have that in common.
Right. Yeah, he's been working out for like 30 years.
He likes younger, beautiful women. So we have that in common.
Right.
But I have a feeling me and your dad won't be having those kind of talks. Probably not a good idea. Oh, my favorite thing to do.
Right.
Yeah. So, but, so we have the gym in common. Yeah. So, yeah. So he'll be like a hangout buddy, fucking workout partner, right?
Yep.
And he's in good shape.
Yep.
All ripped up and shit.
Mm-hmm.
So.
He's all about awesome. The looks.
That's awesome.
He looks more in the mirror than I do.
I find that hard to believe.
No, really. He does.
I find that hard
Where do you think I get it from?
I'm sure... Babe.
What? Out of gas? Again? Nah.
Well, look it.
I don't feel like walking through the drive-thru.
I know. I'm just going to take a fucking chance. But look. Look it. Like, you feel it start to putt a little bit? It's not... It's almost there, but it's not below empty. But I just felt a putt.
Yeah.
Did you feel it?
Yeah.
I'll just take a chance and I'll just push this motherfucker through the drive-thru. Push the car up. Okay, can I get a...
Right.
Yeah, I... Like, people out there, I have a serious, serious memory disorder. And Sarah does too. So the two of us together are just fucking dumb and dumber. And I'm not joking. And, you know, I have abilities in some areas and I have disabilities in other areas. That's what we're all about that. You know, we have positives, we have negatives. And I was diagnosed with a serious memory disorder as a kid. And I had to go to like a special fucking memory class and special fucking speech class. And, you know, I couldn't fucking... talk, you know, as an elementary school. Like, I was fucked up. All right, let me order this food real quick.
Hello, it's Sarah. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
I can help you.
Can I get two charburgers, two double charburgers with extra cheese.
Lettuce wrap, right?
Lettuce wrap.
No,
right, and add bacon on both of those.
Okay.
And then can I also get a double mushroom burger with double Swiss cheese? Lettuce wrap.
You want to add bacon?
Add bacon, please.
Okay, lettuce wrap, add bacon.
Double Swiss cheese.
Double Swiss, and you want double patty, right?
Double patty, and also extra mushrooms. And
right.
They put that on there last night, and it was good.
They put it?
Yeah, well, sometimes I don't think they put extra mushrooms.
I'll make sure they put
last it. Night they did, and it was night and day difference.
Okay.
So, and also, right. And also, I just lost my brain. Caesar salad with tri-tip.
The Caesar with tri-tip? Medium is fine or like well done?
Medium is wonderful.
Medium is fine, okay.
No croutons and extra Parmesan cheese.
Okay.
And
croutons, extra Parmesan, okay.
And two large diet sodas.
No problem. All right, so I'm going to have a two double chars. You want cheese and you want to use the extra cheese?
Yes.
You want those lettuce wraps? And you
want to
do no onions, no pickles, and with bacon.
Right.
Give me a second, sorry.
No problem.
And then you have the mushroom burger, lettuce wrap with bacon, extra patty, extra cheese. And then you want extra mushrooms and the citrus salad with tri-tip, no croutons, extra Parmesan cheese.
Right, and also add bacon on the mushroom burger.
Yeah.
Okay.
Swiss cheese and with bacon, and then extra patty, extra mushrooms. And you want that one lettuce wrap as well?
Yeah, and that one has mushroom. That one also has pickles and onions on it.
Yeah, it comes.
Okay.
It comes with pickles, but it doesn't have onions. Do you want to add the onions?
Sure. That'd be great.
Do you want the grilled onions or raw onions?
Raw onions is good.
Raw onions.
Yeah.
Just the two doubles. You don't want any pickles or the grilled onions, right?
Yeah. No, thank you.
All right. Is that gonna come
for
your order then?
Yep.
All right. It's gonna be
$32.91
at the window.
Okay.
Oh, I ordered the two large
diet sodas. Oh, you got the two diet sodas?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Bye bye.
Alrighty.
Why is it only 32?
I know, last night it was 37 for the same order.
What the hell? Something is missing. Something is missing, right?
Yeah. Either that or she didn't charge us for our extra shit. You know, like the extra cheese, extra mushrooms, and extra bacon. Oh. She might not have charged us for that. You know?
Oh, okay.
That's what I'm guessing. As long as she gives it to us.
Right.
Because I don't give a fuck about charging us for us or, you know, it's like it's night and day difference, the burger with it or without it.
Uh-huh.
Last night, that burger was probably the best fucking burger I ever had in my life.
Oh, yeah?
It was so fucking good. Yeah. And I realized they don't ever put extra mushrooms on it because last night, they put extra mushrooms on it and that shit was fucking good.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I don't know what they do. They marinate their mushrooms in some kind of something that they're fucking outstanding. So people out there, you know, I don't know if you have a habit or if you ever heard of the habit, but you gotta try this shit. It's fucking so good. Their sandwiches are really good. Their burgers. I've been an In-N-Out fan since I was a little kid. I was eating In-N-Out at fucking 3 years old. So, you know, I'm a big time In-N-Out fan, but I'm telling you, man, this place, burgers, blow In-N-Outs away. And that's I know that sounds crazy, and it's crazy coming out of my mouth, but like seriously. And the other night we got both. We got In-N-Out and we got the Habit burgers. So we had one of each. Both same thing, doubles, double cheese, like the same burger, and I'm telling you, man, it was night and day difference.
Mm-hmm. Plus, because they don't have fucking bacon. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, but it's not even the bacon, it's everything. The taste of the, like, I seriously don't think the meat here is as good a quality as In-N-Out.
Yeah.
Honestly, but it fucking tastes
way better.
Yeah, so fuck it. I mean.
Hey, how are you guys?
Hey, what's up, brother?
Good, man.
How you doing?
So we got double char on lettuce wrap, no grilled onions, no pickles, bacon, extra cheese, mushroom burger, lettuce wrap, raw onions, bacon, extra patty, mushrooms, extra cheese, Caesar salad with
extra mushrooms.
Extra mushrooms, exactly. Caesar salad, tri-tip, no croutons, double the parmesan. We got a double char, lettuce wrap as well, no grilled onions, no pickles, avocado, and extra cheese on that one as well, right?
Well, that last thing I don't think was mine. What was the last thing?
Lettuce wrap, no grilled onions, no pickles, avocado, and extra cheese.
No avocado. No. We have three burgers all together.
Three burgers all together.
Avocado.
Yeah, I got three burgers. The mushroom burger, the double char, and another double char.
Yeah.
With avocado?
No
avocado. No avocado.
No.
Avocado.
Oh, it was bacon.
Oh, right? Yeah.
I'm sorry,
yeah.
They put the avocado.
Okay, yeah, add bacon on all three burgers.
All three burgers, yes. Right. And then it's going to be $32.91, please.
Can you grab 91 cents out of here, baby? Sorry. Here's 42. Let me give you 91 real quick.
No worries.
Here, I'll get it. You can film. You're filming. You get the money.
Yeah.
Awesome.
You got ice cream at home, baby? How was that peanut butter? It wasn't that good, huh?
No, not really.
We got some Trader Joe's ice cream last night because we went to Trader Joe's. And would you get peanut butter cup? Peanut butter cup with a caramel swirl or something?
Yeah.
And we got mint chip.
Uh-huh.
How was the mint chip?
Way better than the other one.
It was good. You didn't eat very much of it, though.
No, I know.
10:09 is your change.
Then I just fell asleep.
Thanks, brother.
Did you receive?
Oh, no, thank you. Yeah. Where's the other dude at? Our other guy. I love
right.
Him. He's the shit, man. That guy's cool as fuck, right?
Do you want any ketchup or mustard?
No, thank you. There you go. Don't spoil that shit.
Thank you.
Thanks, my man. Oh, do not let me forget to get gas, babe.
Oh, okay.
No, seriously. Like, do you feel it? It's kind of putting right now.
Yeah.
It's kind of... Yeah. It's going to run out of gas any second. Like, so we got to go straight to the fucking gas station.
Okay.
So fucking stupid. You got to be a fucking idiot. Oh, like what I was saying earlier is... I have a severe memory disorder, and like.
Here you guys go. I got the two doubles on the bottom and the mushrooms right on top.
Okay, thanks, brother. Have a good night.
You too.
All right, man.
Should we check?
Nah. Bye, guys. All right, see you later. Take care. Yeah, so I have a serious memory disorder. Mm-hmm. As a kid, I was fucked in school. Like, I, like, the teacher will tell you something, or I'll read something, or, and they can ask me the question right after, and I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. And that's how you are, too.
I know.
You know, but mine's gotten better over the years.
Mine has not.
Yours has gotten worse and shit.
Yeah, it's really bad.
But, yeah, when I was a little kid, I was in special fucking classes and shit. That's how bad mine was. Like, I had a speech impediment as a kid.
Really?
Yeah, like, I was fucked up.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And, you know, and when I take, there's a certain, where you read and then you answer questions on what you just read,
mm-hmm.
and I fail it every time. Like, no matter what, I
take gas, babe.
What?
Take gas.
Oh, shit. Look, see? I fucking forgot that shit. In 2 seconds, I forgot to get gas. I know people are probably like, oh, that's bullshit. No, seriously, like, I fucking, like, it's really hard to deal with. But there's other things, you know, that make up for it that I'm really good at. So it's like that with everything.
Mm-hmm.
You have, like, people that usually have a really good IQ have a... Oh, look, I'm on the wrong fucking side. Have problems communicating with other people.
Mm-hmm.
I run out of gas all the time. Like, I can fucking take part in running a fucking big company, you know, and have some crazy ass responsibilities that I don't have a problem with. And then simple, stupid shit like fucking remembering, you know, stupid little shit, I can't for the life of me remember.
Join the club, babes.
You know?
Join the Dumber and Dumber Club.
Dumb and Dumber. Fuck it. You know what? It is what it is. You know, it's, you know, it's, I'm the first to admit any fucking flaw I have. The only way to fix it is to first realize it, admit it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's the only way you're gonna fix that shit.
Right. That's true. I can't remember jack shit. So, sucks. Oh, I'm shaking. Actually, let me try 50, see if I can crank that in. Thanks, man. Shaking like crazy.
So Cheesecake Factory hasn't called.
Oh.
Right? What time is it? It's gotta be like, what, 11:20?
Yeah, something like that.
Oh, that's them that was calling.
Oh.
That was my missed call right now. 906-0700, that's Cheesecake Factory. I should have answered.
In your face.
God damn it, I should have answered. Should I call back and say, I was told that you guys would not let me in if I got there at 11. So I got there at 11:01, and the girl was so adamant that she would not let me in that I just left. Because she said she would not let me in no matter what.
Yeah.
Damn it, I should have answered.
Shit.
She's probably happy because she probably didn't take that fucking food home.
Right.
Eat that shit. Take it home to her 5 kids and fucking feed them.
Right. 5 kids.
Oh, yeah, she's probably happy. I remember we used to work at, I used to work at Round Table Pizza. Long time ago, actually 3 years ago. And we used to, I remember I used to make pizzas and act like it was a to-go order, like at right before we closed, and it'd be a fucking double pepperoni, double fucking sausage, extra cheese, like it's so obvious, you know? And then the people wouldn't come, obviously. And I'd be like, oh, man, the people didn't come pick the pizza up. And, of course, the manager's like, well, you can have it if you want it. And I'm like, oh, really? Oh, okay. That's awesome. Thank you so much. You know, then the next night, oh, man, they didn't come pick the pizza up. Fuck. What kind of pizza was it? Believe it or not, it was double pepperoni, double sausage, double cheese. Right? In the build-out. Damn, 24 hours. I can't believe that shit. What does this say? 30-minute customer parking?
Yeah.
You want to wait here or you want to come in? Oh, you got to get ice cream last. You got to come in.
Yeah.
I'm a huge fan of yours.
Oh, hey, what's up, brother? How you doing?
I'm doing good. I watch your video on a day.
Cool.
Every day.
What's your name?
Yes.
Jesse? Oh, yeah, man. Brother.
Yeah, oh. Definitely inspiration for me.
Oh, thank you,
man. Yeah. Yeah, man. I was hoping I'd run into you. I always see your car.
We're always around this area. Yeah, cool.
Yeah, man, it would be cool if I get a picture.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Awesome.
Babe, I think I had on the other on slow-mo.
Are you serious?
When we were picking out the ice cream. Shit.
Awesome, brother.
Hey, for sure, man. Good to meet you.
Videos. Keep doing what you're doing.
Right on, brother. I will. You'll be on this video.
Yeah.
All right, brother.
What the?
God damn it.
Oops.
What the? It's a.
Oh. Oops.
Babe.
Got China in the pool, god damn it.
China girl. Where's the first bee?
Alright, baby. I'm getting in.
We're getting in?
Yeah.
Right?
China, baby. China girl.
China. China, we need to find your sister, baby. We need to find your sister, baby girls. No, baby. We need to find your sister, China. Okay.
You love the pool, huh, China? Oh, you love the pool, baby.
Come on, China. China, come on. Come on, China. Come on, China.
China, come. China, what are you doing?
China. China, come on, let's go. Come on. Come on, China. Come on, China.
Where's the ball, China?
China, come on.
Get the ball.
Come on, China.
Get the ball.
China, come on. China.
Get the ball, China.
Come on, China.
Get the ball. Get the ball.
Come on, China. Come on, China.
Yeah. China girl.
Good
yeah.
Girl, China.
Good girl.
Good girl. Come here, China.
Good. Go to daddy, girl, China.
China.
Aye. She's a cutie. Good girl, China. Yay. Oh, such a good girl.
Good girl, China.
Yay.
Good girl, China.
Come on, China.
Yay.
Come on, China.
At least she came in by herself.
Right?
That was awesome.
Yeah. And mine are here just like, yeah, we're just going to be here with mommy. We are such a little babies. We can't swim.
Which one's more freaked out?
Mule.
Mule is?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She gets really, really scared.
Pigs! 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 Pigs!
Hey guys.
No way. What's it doing?
What am I doing in the water?
Huh? What am I doing in the water?
Have you ever put in the water to swim? Never? You know dogs know how to naturally swim, right?
Yeah.
Want to make her swim?
It's like China girl. I don't know where the fucking frisbee is. Guys. Which is a good girl, China. Oh, there's your ball. China girl. Yeah.
China, give me that ball.
China, give me that ball, China. Yeah, the frisbee, I don't know where it's at, baby. I can't see it anywhere.
It's disappeared.
Yeah, it makes no sense.